Hi, welcome. In our last video, we talked about art as a product of creativity, imagination, and expression. Firstly, art is a product of one's creativity, which can be associated with the word originality, to set his or her work apart from the works of other artists, and to bring something not present into existence. Secondly, art is a product of one's imagination that introduces imaginary works but depict reality and bring significant social change. Lastly, art is a product of expression that displays vivid emotions of the artist, explored by making something beautiful out of them through various art forms, maybe painting, dance, poetry writing, and other related art forms to express their emotions. Now, in this video, we will learn another relevant topic covered in art appreciation: the functions of art. But before getting through the entire video, let's try answering some questions. Do artists craft artworks just to bring something not present into existence and to merely express themselves? Do these artworks serve a great and a specific purpose towards advanced civilization and social change? Let me know what you think by leaving a comment. To start with, function is defined as the role or purpose for which something is designed or created. Given this definition, we may then inquire what art is for. Let's take the monument of Rizal for example. What is the Rizal monument for? Is it for pure sentimental value? Is it for aesthetic value? Or does it send a message to those who witness it? What do you think? Well, to enlighten us on this, it was said that Rizal Monument is a memorial in Rizal Park in Manila, Philippines, built and dedicated by the people of the Philippine Islands to commemorate the executed Filipino nationalist Jose Rizal at the Bagumbayan Field on December 30, 1896. The monument does not only bear a statue of the hero, but also houses his remains. In this sense, we may conclude that Rizal Monument is not merely erected for pure sentimental and aesthetic value, or just to send a message to those who witness it on the historic account that lies behind the erection of the said monument, but significantly holds a greater purpose as a resting place of Rizal's remains. Moving on, functions of art are classified as personal functions, social functions, and physical functions. The personal functions of art are varied and highly subjective. An artist may create an art out of the need for self-expression. It can also be mere entertainment for his intended audience. Also, art may be therapeutic for both parties, the artist and the audience. For the artist, as previously stated, art is done out of the need for self-expression to channel his or her emotions. For the audience, on the other hand, listening to a music, for instance, uplifts our emotions, relieving us from whatever unlikely emotions we feel, for it can mean a multitude of meanings to different people. But originally, music was used for dance and religion, and was seen traditionally as an instrument to facilitate worship and invocation to gods. But today, music has expanded its function and coverage as a medium for self-expression, motivation, and healing. Next, the social functions of art address a particular collective interest as opposed to a personal interest. Art may convey message of protest, contestation, or whatever message the artist intends his work to carry. Sometimes, through art, an artist can successfully convey a message that will benefit the entire society. This is because art can also depict social situations. For example, Rizal's work titled Il Filibusterismo, or The Reign of the Greed, is an artwork that denotes social functions. Accordingly, Il Filibusterismo is Rizal's sequel to his first book, No Limitangri or Touch Me Not. This book exhibits a dark theme that depicts the country's issues in the abuse, corruption, and discrimination of the Spaniards towards Filipinos. Rizal also dedicated his second novel to the Gomboza, which stands for the names of the Filipino martyr priest Mariano Gomez, Jose Borges, and Jacinto Zamora, who were executed on charges of treason. Now, this novel is considered as one of his literary masterpieces that has sparked indirectly the historic Philippine Revolution against the Spanish regime. Last on the list is the physical functions. The physical functions of art are the easiest to spot and understand because these are the kind of artworks crafted or built to serve some physical purposes. Physical purposes relate to items that can be used for a practical purpose because of their physical structure, despite their artistic appeal to give us convenience and comfort. On the list, we have architecture. Industrial, graphic, and interior designing as forms of arts having physical functions. Accordingly, architecture involves designing of buildings, open areas, communities, and other artificial constructions and environments, usually with some regard to aesthetic effect. Architecture often includes design or selection of furnishings and decorations, supervision of construction work, and examination, restoration, or remodeling of existing buildings. Industrial designing is the professional practice of designing products, devices, objects, and services used by millions of people around the world every day. It focuses on the physical appearance, functionality, and manufacturability of a product. Every object that we interact with on a daily basis at home, office, school, or public setting is a result of industrial designing to bring convenience and comfort into our lives. Graphic designing is the creation of visual content to communicate messages. It involves a creative and systematic plan to solve a problem or achieve certain objectives with the use of images, symbols, or even words to visually communicate and aesthetically express concepts. And interior designing advises on the interior layout of a building and proposes various reconfigurations, as well as recommending products and services. It also generates 2D or 3D plans and schedules for each product, layout plans for tiles, heating and electrical socket plans for locations and functions. Now, in conclusion, it has been shown that most forms of art are functional, but still there are some which are not. However, it is important to note that the value of an artwork is not defined by its function, but by the work itself. We do not devalue an art when it serves no practical function other than its aesthetic and sentimental value. And that's it for the functions of art. May this video help you understand the concepts presented and discussed. Thank you very much for watching.